key to remember with biosecurity is that we know we've got numerous non-native invasive species in this country, such as the various invertebrate species and plant species. And obviously the key with those is they can be transported very easily. Some of them are very small, a lot of the plants, it only requires a small piece of leaf or node or stem, and they can very quickly regrow. But of course the other issue to remember is there's lots of other species that could potentially create an issue in the problem. So making sure you're being as biosecure as possible is the best thing we can do to protect the environment.
We spend so much time and are so diligent, whether it be boaters, whether it be anglers, you know, whatever discipline we're following, is that we're so diligent in making sure that the kit we take off site, and that's the important part, it's not what you're not going to take onto another site, is make sure that you are not taking anything off site. So yes, in what we've been doing on this particular occasion today is focusing on floating pennywort. But you know, so that's great. People are, you know, we're washing off boats, we're power washing SUPs and so on and so forth. But is that to say that when you leave this site, you're going to check your boots, for example, to make sure that you haven't got fragments of invasive plant species within the tread of your boots? And that's how diligent we now need to be in terms of ensuring that we, you know, we've already got a problem. We're spending £1.7 billion a year in the UK on managing, and I stress the word managing, not controlling, but managing invasive species. And, you know, that's unsustainable. We've got to find a better solution to that, and biosecurity done correctly is that solution.
So with the check, clean, dry process, obviously that process is going to vary depending on the sort of kit that you're looking to ensure is going to be biosecure, whether you're an angler or a boater, a paddle boarder, etc. But obviously the first step of that, checking it, so you want to lay out your kit, make sure you can check visually all areas of it, and particular things to be concerned about are where you might have folds or little hidden pockets or areas where you might have materials get caught up out of sight. So checking the kit as a whole visually, making sure that there's nothing obvious on it. The next stage is then cleaning it. So again, depending on the kit, if you've got a larger item, might be a paddleboard or a canoe, you might have a pressure washer where you can thoroughly pressure wash it down. Angling equipment, you might look at disinfecting it. So using a conventional disinfectant product to disinfect and thoroughly clean that kit. And then finally dry. So we always recommend thoroughly drying kit, because in its own right, that's a way of killing off many non-native species, also things like bacteria and viruses as well, so particularly if that's dried in UV, so strong sunlight.
We need to make people understand how long these individual species can survive out of their normal environment, whether that be a water environment and ground environment. But if you took a water environment, for example, and an angler, if you took home a damp keep net, for example, or landing net that has that's got invasive species on it, any one of any number that we could mention, simple fact of the matter is, in the right conditions, they could still well be live when you reintroduce that net 2 weeks later, or maybe even longer. So that's why this check, clean, dry, disinfect, check, clean, dry. You just can't emphasize enough how important that whole concept is.
I think what we are really seeing is the improvement in getting the message out and raising public awareness, and a lot of that has come from support partner organisations, which is great to see. Obviously that is key, because public awareness is massive. Not only does it provide us support such as volunteers like we've had here today on the River Wey, but also in terms of reporting, the sooner we know about invasive species, in terms of their presence and their location, the sooner we can deal with them. And again, talking about those future species, the sooner you identify an issue, the easier it is to deal with. If it's a few years down the line and that species has had an opportunity to spread and become more prevalent, then it's always going to be a lot harder to deal with and a lot more expensive to deal with.
whether it's your Wellington boots, your boats, your fins, whatever, your wetsuit, dry suit, making sure that any of that is as clean as it possibly can be before you take it off site. Then when you get home, you know, in a safe environment, finish it off, make sure it's absolutely right, then take the opportunity to hang it out UV light, couple of days, and Bob's your uncle, you're safe to go.